Next, welcome friends. I am today doing unit 5 of MOM, that is CAMS. Now, what is the definition of CAM? A CAM is defined as a rotating machine element. A CAM always rotates, which gives a oscillatory or reciprocatory motion to another machine element called the follower. This is the definition, very compact definition of a CAM. It is a rotating machine element which gives a predetermined oscillatory or reciprocatory motion to another machine element known as the follower or called as the follower. So wherever there is a CAM, there will be a follower. CAM and follower go along with each other, right? So that is the definition of CAM. I think you have understood. It is a rotating machine element which gives a reciprocating or oscillatory motion, predetermined reciprocatory or oscillatory motion to another machine element called the follower. Now, these CAMs are broadly can be classified into two types. One is disk or edge CAM, disk or edge CAM, and the other is cylindrical CAM. These are the two types of CAMs we have. We can classify them into two types. One is called as the edge or disk CAM, and the other is called as the this thing. Now, this disk or edge CAM, this is the CAM shaft. On that, this is the CAM. This is called the profile of the CAM. This will be keyed to a CAM shaft. Here, we will have a follower. This is called as the follower. When this shaft rotates, this will also rotate. When this rotates, this will go like this. This will reciprocate like this. So, this is called as the follower. This is called the CAM. This is called the follower. Now, in a cylindrical CAM, the CAM is like this. It rotates this way. Here is a groove. A groove is there of some shape. That shape depends upon the motion we have to give to the follower. So, this is having a slot here. A slot something like this will be there. Now the follower will come here, and it is as this CAM rotates, this follower reciprocates like this in this direction. This is called as a cylindrical CAM. Here the follower, the motion of the follower is perpendicular to the axis of the camshaft. Here, the motion of the follower is parallel to the axis of the camshaft. That is the main difference between a disk CAM and a cylindrical CAM. Now, you get a problem. Always, you get one problem in CAM where you will have to draw this figure, which is called the profile, CAM profile. Now, the motion of the follower, how it goes, when it goes up, when it comes down, how much it will go up, how it will go up, how it will come down, all that depends upon this profile. Now, they will give you all the conditions required here, how it should go up, how much it should go, when it should go up, and when it should come back, when it should remain in the same position, all that will be given. Based on that information, we will have to draw this profile. That will fetch you about 10, 11, 12 marks, 10 to 12 marks. Now, this we have only these problems. We don't have these problems. Just you must know what is a cylindrical CAM and what is a disk CAM or edge CAM. The difference between these two. The problem will come in this, where you will have to draw this profile. This profile is to be drawn based on the information of the motion of the follower. Now, if you don't do it correctly, then this motion will not get, you will not get that motion. Now, for example, in one place where it is used is for closing and opening of the valves in a four-stroke IC engine. Now, it should, you see, you know, the inlet valve should open when the suction is taking place. Exhaust valve must open when exhaust stroke or scavenging is taking place. Now, if you don't draw this profile correctly and the cam is manufactured according to our profile, then when the valve should be closed, it may not be closed. When it should be open, it may not be open. So, such a thing will happen and thereby your engine will not work. So, this is the importance of this. Now, we have this disc cam. They are classified further into rise return cam, rise dwell return. Dwell means it will remain there only. RD, rise dwell return dwell, like this they can be classified. They can be classified into different types like that. Then the followers, type of followers maybe knife edge. You can have a knife edge follower. If a knife edge follower is given, this is how it is. It is a cylindrical rod having an edge like this, like a screwdriver. It will be there. This is called as knife edge follower. This, if this follower is given, they don't give any dimension. You have to simply mark it like this. And no dimension is necessary. This has some disadvantage. The disadvantage is this is having a sharp edge. So as it is in contact always with the cam, it can cause lot of wear and tear. The second one is the roller follower. Here you have a roller which is free to rotate. It is like this. When a roller follower is given, its dia will be given. They will give the dia of the roller. Then you have mushroom follower. Normally this is not used. Mushroom follower will be like this. It may be flat or it may be like this, circular. So they will have point or line contact. They will not cause wear and tear. So these are the followers. Generally, they give either a knife edge follower or a roller follower. Then the motion of the follower, that is during rise and return, there are different types of motion. Follower motion can be different types. One is called uniform velocity. Then second one, simple harmonic motion, that is also called as SHM. Then uniform and equal acceleration and retardation or deceleration. These three motions are important for us. They will give the going and coming back, going up and returning. Both may be by same, or it may go up by one motion and come back by another motion. There is one more, cycloidal motion, which will not be asked. So these three motions are important. Then this follower may be radial, that is the axis of the follower when it is produced is passing through the axis of the cam, or it can be slightly offset so that the load on this is lesser. It can be offset by a few millimeters, that will be given. It may be either radial or offset, that will be given. Now if it is uniform velocity, now while going up it will go like this in a straight line path. While coming down, if it is uniform velocity, it will slide like this, right? It will come back like this. Then it is uniform velocity. The displacement diagram will be like that. If it is SHM, then if this is the angle of ascent means going up, descent means coming down, this will be the lift, of the follower, that is the lift or the throw of the follower, that is the distance, maximum distance by it, which it will go up. Now with this as diameter, you draw a semicircle here. A semicircle is drawn. It is divided into 6 or 4 equal parts. Then if you divide it into 6 equal parts, this angle also must be divided into 6 equal parts. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then this is the starting point. This is the next point. This is the third point. This is the fourth point. This is the fifth point. This is the next point. This is the next point. It will go like this. Like this. This curve is not important. What is important is the distance covered by the follower in each division. That is important. While coming back also, it will come like that. In uniform acceleration and retardation, for the displacement diagram will be like this. This, if this is the angle, then it should be divided into 4 or 6 or 8 equal parts. Then this middle line must be divided into same number of equal parts. Then this is these lines like this. Now these are the distances, important distances. So it will come like this. It will go like that and return also similar way. So this is how this thing should be drawn. If it has no this thing, what you have to do is, first you have to draw base circle, then the minimum radius circle, then if it is a roller follower, you have to place the roller. Then this is here, this is called as the pitch circle. Then divide while going up, how many parts you have divided in the displacement diagram, same number of equal parts here, transfer these distances on them and draw these rollers with them as center, and then draw the profile like this. So it will be there for some time, it will dwell. And then it will start coming back and come and join here. Like this it will come. So this is how it will come. If it is a radial follower. If it is an offset follower. If the follower is offset. This is the minimum radius circle. This is the offset circle. How much it is offset you have to draw. So the follower will come here. Now this is the reference line, the zero line. In the previous case, this was the zero line. Now that is the zero line. From here, you have to divide this, draw the pitch circle, divide this into same number of parts, and then tangents are to be drawn to the offset circle. This circle is called as the offset circle. Now the distances must be transferred on the tangents, on these tangents 1, 2, 3. Then the rollers must be drawn. And then this must be come. The profile must be generated. So that's how it is to be done. I don't have instruments here. I can't show it on a board. So you will have to do it on your own. And if you have any difficulty, you have to inquire with me. You have to ask me for clarifications. If you have anything, you can ask me by calling me. You can ask those clarifications. I think you have understood these points, the important points. Thank you so much.